Hi, my name is Delaine, and I'll be your nurse for this telehealth visit. I understand that you have some questions about tuberculosis. I'm here to educate you on this disease and hopefully answer any questions that you may have at this time. Let's get started. Tuberculosis is an infection caused by Mycobacterium tuberculosis, a bacteria which commonly affects the respiratory system, but can also develop throughout the body. In respiratory TB, bacteria enters the lungs, triggering an inflammatory immune response. Healthy individuals control the infection by encapsulating and suppressing the bacteria, resulting in latent, asymptomatic infection. In individuals with weakened immune system, like those with HIV or the elderly population, bacteria is encapsulated by the immune cells, resulting in caseation, also known as a granuloma. The centers of these capsules die, resulting in caseous necrosis. Over time, these capsules are surrounded by fibrous materials and are referred to as a gone focus, which can also be seen as dense consolidations on chest x-rays. TB can also infect hilar lymph nodes, resulting in additional areas of caseous necrosis, which is then referred to as gone complex. If the immune system is weak enough, the bacteria continues to multiply and spread to other areas within the lungs and throughout the body via the lymph system. Tuberculosis is highly infectious and can spread via airborne droplets through breathing, talking, coughing, sneezing, or eating. While tuberculosis is curable with extensive long-term antibiotic administration, it remains the leading cause of death for curable infections worldwide. Common symptoms experienced by an individual with active tuberculosis includes flu-like symptoms, fever, coughing, night sweats, blood-tinged sputum, and weight loss. In an article written by Heumann, Henson, and others, and published by the Journal of Tropical Diseases, Travel Medicine, and Vaccines, the presence of cardiovascular disease resulting in inflammation can stimulate or trigger inflammation in the lungs, leading to activation of latent TB bacteria and active infection. Conversely, they also suggest that tuberculosis infection may also attribute to cardiovascular disease development through tuberculosis granuloma formation in coronary arteries, which may increase incidence of myocardial infarction or sudden cardiac death. Granuloma development in peripheral vasculature may play a role in the development of peripheral artery disease. According to the World Health Organization, approximately 1.8 billion people worldwide are infected with tuberculosis as of 2019. However, around 90 to 95% of those individuals have a latent form of the infection, where their immune systems are capable of suppressing the infection, therefore preventing manifestation of symptoms and the ability to transmit the disease. These individuals are typically unaware that they carry the disease at all. According to the Centers for Disease Control and Prevention, 8,916 cases of tuberculosis were confirmed in the United States throughout 2019, for an incidence rate of approximately 2.7 affected individuals per every 100,000 individuals. Cases are more prevalent among newly immigrated individuals and in areas where living standards result in close living quarters and poor sanitation, as well as medically underserved communities. Various tests are commonly used to identify individuals with tuberculosis. The most common test includes the purified protein derivative, or PPD, intradermal skin test, also commonly referred to as the Manteau test or the tuberculin skin test. This test is performed by injecting tuberculin, a common component of the tuberculosis bacterium, between the upper layers of the skin. A positive PPD test is indicated by a raised induration that develops within 2 to 3 days following the injection, which indicates an immune response. One drawback for this test is that it cannot differentiate between latent or active infection. Another test performed is the interferon gamma release assay, or IGRA. A blood test that assesses the body's immune response to the tuberculin bacteria. Two advantages of the IGRA test include being able to receive results within 24 hours and the fact that it is less likely to result in false positive test results for individuals who have received the BCG immunization. If an individual receives a positive test for either method, a chest x-ray is performed to assess for signs of active infection, such as consolidations that are indicative of cavitation caused by tissue necrosis. With nucleic acid amplification testing, sputum samples can also be cultured for the presence of bacteria to confirm active infection. While treatment for TB, in most cases, is covered by government sources or insurance companies, the impact of long-term treatment regimens has other financial drawbacks, such as the inability to work while under isolation, resulting in loss of wages. In an article written by Castro, Marx, and others, the estimated societal economic benefit of averting TB cases through prompt diagnosis, treatment, and implementation of preventative measures is ranged between 6.7 and 14.5 billion US dollars between the years of 1995 to 2014. This approximation does not take into consideration the cost of lost productivity due to burden of disease and premature death. There are various techniques used to prevent the spread of tuberculosis. For individuals from high-risk populations, such as immigrants from certain countries, and individuals from long-term care facilities or correctional facilities, the Bacillus Calmette-Guérin vaccine can be provided for immunity. However, the BCG vaccine is not commonly recommended for individuals in the United States due to low risk of infection and variable effectiveness of the vaccine. High-risk individuals, also including healthcare workers, should be screened yearly for early detection and treatment. Individuals diagnosed with TB who are receiving treatment in a medical facility should be placed on airborne isolation in a negative airflow room. Healthcare workers should use an N95 respirator and barrier protection for skin and clothing. Individuals undergoing treatment at home should be educated on minimizing close contact with housemates, spending more time outdoors or in well-ventilated rooms, and avoiding settings with densely packed individuals, such as public transportation. All individuals with TB should be advised to maintain a well-balanced diet with adequate fluid intake, strictly adhere to their medication schedules, and cough into their elbows and spit out sputum into tissues, which should be properly disposed of. Tuberculosis is a major public health concern. Treatment for tuberculosis often requires a mix of antibiotic medications that will need to be taken over the span of several months. This, combined with the fact that side effects related to medication use may be unpleasant, increases the risk for non-compliance. As a result, multi-drug-resistant tuberculosis is becoming more prevalent, according to the Centers for Disease Control and Prevention. Drug-resistant TB is especially problematic due to the fact that it usually takes longer to treat successfully, which increases burden of disease and economic impact. This can lead to frustration and further failure to comply with the medication regimen, further increasing the risk for transmission and disease progression. Some strategies that can help prevent development of multi-drug-resistant TB includes educating patients on the importance of adhering to their medication schedule and taking their full course of antibiotic medications as prescribed. Additionally, there are public health programs in place that involve directly observed therapy, where administration of antibiotics are overseen by public health professionals, such as a nurse in a clinical site, to ensure treatment cooperation. I hope that this helped you better understand the disease process and impact of tuberculosis. Now we can discuss any further questions or concerns you may have.